Hello everyone. Let's start with Plant Kingdom chapter. In this chapter, we will study the five main groups which are involved in Plant Kingdom. That is algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms. But how do we classify all these plants into different groups? What criteria do we use to classify plants in these different groups? So let's try to understand this in this video. So, if you look at the entire plant kingdom, it is very diverse, right? You have very diverse kinds of plants. Some produce seeds, some do not produce seeds. Some produce flowers, some do not produce flowers. Some look like typical plants with proper root, stem, leaves, right? But some plants do not have root, stem, leaves, but they still belong to the plant kingdom, right? So, what criteria do we use to classify all the plants into these five groups? Let's try to understand this. So, first we have to look whether the plant body is differentiated or not. Differentiated plant body means the plant should have root, stem, and leaves, or at least root-like, stem-like and leaf-like structures. But when we look at the lower plants like algae, like in this picture, we have fucus. And we have many different species of algae. Like you must be knowing about Spirogyra, which is filamentous, thread-like structure. Now, do these forms have root, stem and leaves? No, they do not even have any similar structures. So, the plants which do not have root, stem and leaves or any similar structure means their plant body is undifferentiated. Such plants are placed in group algae. This represents the lower plant group, lowest plant group rather, right? Next, we are left with all the plants which show at least a little differentiated plant body. But still there is huge diversity in it. So we use few more criteria to classify them further. So plants which have differentiated plant body can be classified into different groups based on whether they have vascular tissues, that is xylem and phloem, or they do not have vascular tissues. So plants which show little differentiation in their structure, but they do not have vascular tissues. That is, they do not have xylem and phloem for conduction of water, minerals, food, right? So, aise plants ko hum kya bolenge? Non-vascular plants. And all the plants which are non-vascular but with little differentiated plant body are called bryophytes. So, different groups like liverworts and mosses, common mosses which flourish mainly in the rainy season, they are involved in bryophytes. Next, we are left with all the plants which have xylem and phloem. That means these are vascular plants. But still, all the vascular plants show huge diversity. So we classify them further. Based on what? Based on whether they produce seeds or not. So, as we can see here on the screen, there are some vascular plants which do not produce seeds, and the remaining ones obviously produce seeds. So the plants which do not produce seeds but bear the vascular tissues are called pteridophytes. Inko hum kya bolenge? Pteridophytes, right? Yes, like here you can see pteridophytes. Common ferns are involved in this group. So far we have seen algae, bryophytes and pteridophytes. These three groups are like lower plant groups. They do not produce seeds. Also, the reproductive organs in these three groups are hidden. They are not very clearly visible. And hence, collectively, these three groups, that is algae, bryophytes and pteridophytes, are called cryptogams. Okay, because they have hidden reproductive organs, or you can just remember it as they do not produce seeds. So they are called cryptogams. Now, let's see the next group, that is plants which have differentiated plant body. They have vascular tissues and they produce seeds, right? Seeds are produced. Now let's see how the seeds are produced here. Whether the seeds produced are not covered by any fruit pore, right? That means these seeds are naked. And next will be whether the seeds are enclosed. Whether the seeds are enclosed. Okay. So, enclosed in what? Basically the fruit wall. So, simply plants which produce seeds, but the seeds are not covered by any fruit wall, means the seeds are directly visible, they are naked. These plants are called gymnosperms. Okay, like common pine tree, cycas, such plants are gymnosperms. These plants do not produce flowers, do not produce fruits also, but they do produce seeds. These are gymnosperms. And last but not the least, we have angiosperms. Last group kaun sa hai hamare paas? Angiosperms. That is flowering plants, right? It is very diverse group. Here, seeds are produced and they are basically enclosed or covered in a fruit wall. So, simply the most advanced plant group which produce flowers, it produces seeds which are covered by fruit wall. That means fruits are also produced. This group is called angiosperms. And this is how we have categorized all the different plant species into five groups. Algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes. Then we have gymnosperms and angiosperms. Next, gymnosperms and angiosperms. These two plant groups have clearly visible reproductive structures. Right? Means here the reproductive structures are not hidden. And one common thing is again they produce seeds. Right? Here seeds are produced which will ultimately germinate to produce new plants. So collectively gymnosperms and angiosperms are called phanerogams. Inko hum kya bolte hai? Phanerogams. Okay? So remember, algae, bryophytes and pteridophytes are called cryptogams and gymnosperms and angiosperms are called phanerogams. So, this is how we classify all the millions of species of plants into different groups. These are the five groups. Now, in the upcoming video lectures, we will study all the groups in detail. I hope this video was helpful for you. Thank you.